Hey, today we're going to do a video for atheists. Father God, help us to understand your word and put it in practice in the name of Jesus. Do you know, atheists, they say, there's no heaven, there's no hell. There's no God, nothing. So, the thing that boggles the mind that many atheists, they're not enjoying this life. And they have morals. But this is stupid to have morals, you know, because really, do you know, God says in the Bible, he says in Revelation chapter 3, I would you were cold, or I would you were hot. It says that to Christians. And besides this, do you know that Jesus is very angry to most Christianity because he debates with atheists. And just many Christians will come and say, let us say in heaven. And Jesus will say, depart from me. You work iniquity, I don't know you. So Jesus will say to many Christians that they will not enter heaven. And what boggles the mind is that many atheists, they're not enjoying this life. You know, you ask an atheist girl to have sex with you, she says, oh no, I'm not going to have sex with you. And you know, what's very interesting is that, what I think is that she's going to hell. She's not going to heaven. She don't believe in God. She's going to burn. Why are you trying to be moral in this life when you're going to burn forever, going to be destroyed? What is your morality giving you? So just because society tells you to do something, you do what society tells you? This is stupid. I mean, if I was atheist, I would just enjoy life, cocaine, drugs, and get high, and it would be... But even though God allows you to do many things to enjoy life, and that's funny. So that's the goal of this video today, is that many atheists they don't believe God, they don't believe heaven or anything or judgment or anything, but they're not enjoying life. This is what amazes me. They're prudish. Atheist women, they're prudish. They don't want to have sex. They don't want to do this or that. But why you do that? You're going to hell. Just enjoy now. Because if you keep living in a few years, you're gonna die, you're gonna be destroyed. See, if you don't enjoy life right now, you will never enjoy your life. You're atheist, just enjoy now, especially if you're young. So what it shows me is that atheists don't believe the truth of the Bible, which is true, but they believe the moral codes of society. And if you go to the book of the Bible, in Revelation, it says that the kings of the earth, the presidents, the leaders of the world will hide themselves under a rock and say, hide us from the face of him who stands on the throne and from the Lamb. Because the leaders of the world, presidents, army generals, they will hide themselves. They will know they are wicked and will be destroyed. So this is one of the most amazing things I see every day. I go see atheists and they see, oh, but if you're an atheist, you can have morals. What is your moral doing if you're going to die in a few years? You can be 20 now. You know, life passes very fast. If you're a woman, you know, when you're 45, 40, you're not going to bang any guy anymore. That's finished. You just enjoy now. Because when you get 40 years old, that's finished. You're not begging anybody. Most women from 50 to 80, they're finished. They have no sex, no dick, nothing. And they say, oh, I'm not going to have sex. Oh, yeah, but you're going to die soon. You're going to go to hell. Because, you know, the reason why atheists are atheists is because they have no knowledge of the Bible. You ask many atheists, they have no clue what the Bible says. This is the reason why they're atheists. They don't know. If they knew all the prophecies of the Bible, all the details of the Bible, they would become Christian. Because you can go around the fact that the Bible is true. They have many prophecies. The 1260 days prophecy, the 2300 days prophecy, Islam in the Bible in chapter 9 Revelation, the French Revolution. There's so many prophecies in the Bible that it is true. It is true. But they have the mindset of Catholicism that you have to work your way to heaven. So, if I don't do that, maybe a society gives me a point. Who cares about society giving you any point? You live your life. And the thing is that not just women, but men also, they have many atheists that have moral standards. But why you need moral standards? You're going to die. you're going to be destroyed very soon. And if you don't enjoy your life now, you will never enjoy, because if you keep being atheist, very soon God will destroy you, because God cannot have atheists in heaven. How do we know that? Because the book of Romans says they will have no excuse when you come into the judgment of God in front of him, and you will stand before the bar of God with millions of angels around, and God will ask you why you believe such a thing, right? You will have no excuse. The Bible says your mouth will be stopped because you will not know what to say, because the evidence of creation is all over. You have light, you have sun, you have trees, you have colors. These cannot evolve. Why? Because natural selection has no brain. It cannot decide something to be such a way or a different way. Natural selection cannot... God made natural selection to preserve species, but evolution and natural selection has no brain, no thought, no planning. If you don't plan something, you never have anything. This mouse here, someone planned the size, the color, the material, the function, right? So anything that exists, came from intelligence and from planning. A car, a pen, a shoe, television, phone, anything that exists, even music. When you make a song, you have to decide the length of the song, you have to decide everything. So if you don't decide something before you make it, this thing will never come to pass. So this is why everything you see in creation, so if you're talking with something which is dead, like a mouse or a phone, how much more plants, animals, and human beings which are much more intelligent. So this is the call of the video, is the amazing stupidity of evolutionists who try to have moral standards which they follow in fact society, but they try to have moral standards in this society, the which God says himself that this society is wicked. This society is totally corrupt and wicked. The Bible says that most people will be destroyed very soon. And the laws of human, we have to follow the rules of this world, because God says we have to obey governments. But the stupidity of most people is that they believe that because they obey governments, they're a good person. No! You can pay your taxes. You can drive 55 in America. In France, it's 120 kilometers. It depends on every country. You can follow all the laws of your country and be a very wicked person. You can be selfish, aggressive, proud, traitor. You can be a very wicked person. In fact, you can be the leader of a country, like Hitler, and be a very wicked person. You can make the laws of your country and be led by Satan. So following the rules of your country, you have to, because God says you have to. But it's not because you follow the rules of the country, you become a good person. The moral standards are much higher. You cannot be proud. You can be selfish. You cannot be a traitor. And you can be unbelieving. You cannot be dishonest. So these things... much more, and there's many more like this. So this is why this society is so stupid. They're following everything society tells you to do, but they don't realize society is wicked itself. So if you follow the rules of the society, you just are following an evil society. See, if you're an atheist, you know, God would rather have a Satanist who worships Satan and does evil things than a lukewarm atheist, which is just in the middle. You're not enjoying your life, you're following society. God doesn't care about you if you're following society and following these rules. God wants you to follow the truth. Either you be totally in the truth or totally into evil. Don't stay in the middle. Father God, thank you for your word, and may people put it in practice. In the name of Jesus, amen.